Hola estudiantes y bienvenidos a la clase de español con la maestra Verónica. Hoy aprenderemos los artículos indefinidos. Today we're going to learn indefinite articles. And the first thing that I always like to start with is el vocabulario. So let's start. Insecto. Insect. Una mosca. A fly. Una abeja. A bee. Una chinche. A bed bug. Un mosquito. A mosquito. Una pulga. A flea. Una cucaracha. A roach. Una mariposa. A butterfly. Un piojo. A lice. Un mayate. A June beetle. Una mariquita. A ladybug. Una hormiga. An ant. Una araña. A spider. Una cigarra. A cicada. Una mantis religiosa. A praying mantis. Un alacrán. A scorpion. Una libélula. Or you can also say, un caballito del diablo. A dragonfly. Un cien pies. A centipede. Un grillo. A cricket. Una oruga. A caterpillar. Un chapulín. A grasshopper. So, let's start our lesson now. What are indefinite articles? Indefinite articles are words that are placed before a noun. Indefinite articles, in English, we have a, and some. In Spanish, we have un, unos, una, and unas. We use indefinite articles when we are referring to a noun that is not specific or particular. For example, do you see a firefly? In Spanish we say, si ves una luciérnaga. As you can see, the firefly has not been identified. It could be any firefly. That's why it's called indefinite. Indefinite articles have a gender in Spanish. There can either be masculine or feminine. And indefinite articles and nouns, when they are together, they have to agree on their gender. What about number? Indefinite articles can also be plural or singular. Singular meaning only one, plural meaning two or more. Due to this fact, indefinite articles and nouns, when they're together, they have to agree on their number also. So how do we know if an indefinite article is masculine or feminine, plural or singular? Well, there's four forms. We have the masculine singular form, un, and then we have the masculine plural, unos. We have the feminine singular, una, and we have the feminine plural, unas. When using definite articles with any noun, make sure they match the gender and number. Let's see. We have masculine singular, un, masculine plural, unos, feminine singular, una, and feminine plural, unas. Un, unos, una, unos. To say a butterfly, how we say in Spanish? Let's see. Let's find the noun. Let's find out if the noun is masculine or feminine or singular or plural. Let's see. We know that in Spanish, butterfly is mariposa. So, Mariposa ends with an A. We have learned that most nouns that end with an A are feminine. And we know in here that we're just referring to one butterfly. So, okay, we know that mariposa is feminine singular noun. Now we have to find the matching indefinite article. We need an indefinite article that is feminine and that is singular. We have the feminine singular noun, una. This is the one that we use for this particular noun. Una mariposa, una, feminine singular, mariposa, feminine singular. Okay, let's try another one. Some mosquitoes. Let's figure out what mosquitoes is in Spanish. We know that mosquitoes is mosquitos. Very easy, right? So, mosquitos is plural because it has an S. And it ends with a no. So, we know and we learn that most nouns that end with a no are masculine. So, mosquito is a masculine plural noun. Now we have to find the matching indefinite article. We want the indefinite article that is masculine plural. We know that masculine plural is unos. So we put unos with mosquitos. Unos mosquitos. And then you have the matching indefinite article with the noun. Now let's say a cricket. We know that cricket is masculine because it ends with a no. Grillo. So, grillo is masculine, and we know we're referring to only one, so it's singular. So, we find the matching indefinite article, masculine, singular, un. So, we put it in front of the noun, un grillo. We have these two matching noun and article. Let's go to another example. How do we say in English, how do we say in Spanish some spiders? Well, first, we know that spiders are arañas. Arañas is plural because it has an S. And before the S, it has an A. That means that noun in the singular form ends with an A. So we know that most nouns that end with an A are feminine. So, arañas is a feminine plural noun. Now we have to find the matching indefinite article. We need a feminine plural article. Feminine plural article is unas. So we put it in front of the noun. Unas arañas. We have an indefinite article that is feminine plural and a noun that is feminine plural. Okay. Now, let's practice. It's your turn. This is what I'm going to do. I'm going to ask you this question. ¿Qué insecto es este? What type of insect is this? Then I'm going to show you the picture. After you see the picture, I'm going to turn the page and you are going to, before you turn the page, guess what article, what indefinite article supposed to go with the noun. In this case, mosca. So you can respond, es una mosca. So let's try. ¿Qué insecto es este? Es una mantis religiosa. ¿Qué insecto es este? Es una libélula. ¿Qué insecto es este? Es una pulga. ¿Qué insecto es este? Es un mayate. ¿Qué insecto es este? Es un piojo. ¿Qué insectos son estos? Now we're asking the plural. Son unos cien pieses. ¿Qué insectos son estos? Son unas chinches. ¿Qué insectos son estos? Son unas mantis religiosas. ¿Qué insectos son estos? Son unos alacranes. ¿Qué insectos son estos? Son unos grillos. Bueno, estudiantes, esto es todo por ahora. Tengan un buen día. Adiós.